We've previously talked about NHL draft busts before, and they all seem to have one thing in common. Besides the fact that they didn't pan out, there always seems to be something odd or wrong that makes them fall off, whether that be refusing to do what the coach asks, or flat out not wanting to improve on a weak spot of their game. Well, the player we'll be discussing about did both of those things, making the pattern seem even more relevant. But perhaps it could be argued that his attitude and posture may have gotten the best of him. Today, we'll be looking back on what went wrong with the once promising forward Nikita Filatov. Before we begin, I want to give a huge shout out to SeatGeek for sponsoring today's video. SeatGeek is an app that allows users to purchase tickets to games, concerts, and live events. SeatGeek makes buying tickets simple as they rate them on a scale of 1 to 100. The higher the number, the better the deal. So if you haven't already, use my promo code IDGT at checkout to save $20 off your first purchase. Now, let's get into it. Filatov played minor hockey with the CSKA hockey system until age 15, where he would take it to the next level. Making his appearance on the junior team, Filatov would average 3 points per game, as well as making his U18 appearance for Russia in 2006. Things would only go up from here, as the following season, Filatov would make his professional debut in the RSL with CSKA, only playing 5 games. He'd decide to continue playing in junior, where he'd produce 23 goals and 24 assists in 23 games. Filatov was dominant in Russia, and was ranked the number 1 European prospect headed into the 2008 draft. Some are even stating that he was the next best thing to Steven Stamkos. After the season ended, the Columbus Blue Jackets possessed the 6th overall pick, and decided to select him. However, GM Scott Housen made it very clear that Filatov would have to earn his roster spot, stating, quote, "We've already told Nikita that we'll see how things go in training camp and we'll decide what's best for him." This wouldn't go well with Nikita, and this quote would start the long list of controversy that was to come. Filatov wouldn't make the team come training camp, and would be sent down to the AHL. Although, at first, head coach Ken Hitchcock had some high praise for Filatov, comparing him to a young Pavel Bure. His mindset would quickly change soon after. Filatov would split time between the NHL and AHL, but during his time with the Jackets, he'd only tally 4 points, and 3 came from the same game where he scored a hat trick against Minnesota. After a very underwhelming first season, things began to change drastically between management and Filatov, eventually leading to the end of Filatov's career. Reports surfaced about tensions between Filatov and Ken Hitchcock. This time around, he'd make the team, but didn't play in 6 of the team's first 18 games, even though he was completely healthy. This decision was made by Hitchcock, and Filatov became unhappy with his playing time and role on the team. Things would get even worse when rumors came out that Filatov refused to play the way the Jackets asked of him. His quote was seen everywhere, as Filatov stated in practice when asked to work on his defensive play, quote, "Philly don't do rebounds." After being unhappy with the Jackets organization, Filatov requested to return to Russia for the remaining of the season, and his request was accepted. Filatov would play the rest of the season in Russia, and would eventually get traded to the Senators for a 3rd-round pick at the draft that season. Once arriving in Ottawa, Filatov brought even more controversy along with him. It was reported that Filatov was promised a spot on the first or second line and the power play by the Sens GM before training camp even finished. This came as shocking, considering Filatov has done nothing to deserve the top line minutes and nothing but raw potential at the time. The statement was made by Filatov, and it only proved how entitled he'd become. Filatov didn't want to work for top line minutes, and was at most times immature. This led to limited playing time once again in Ottawa. He'd only produced 1 point in 9 games before being sent down to the AHL. He tallied 12 points before once again wanting to leave for Russia. This didn't go well with Ottawa management, as head coach Paul MacLeod felt, quote, "that Filatov's struggles were surprising, and that he hoped that Filatov would have stayed and worked on his game in Binghamton." Filatov would return to Russia once again, except this time, never returning to an NHL team. His NHL career was over, after just 4 years in the league. Some could argue that Filatov ended his own career, while others can argue that he was just never meant to play in the NHL. But in the end, Filatov never met up to his high expectations. For a player who was once considered to be selected first overall, he was a huge disappointment. Regardless if you like your position on a team or not, you should still give it your all, and handle it as maturely as possible. And then maybe, once given a second chance, you could finally be as good as the man selected ahead of you. And as for Filatov, he had some hard competition from day one, as the man projected ahead of him would dominate for years to come.